Okay, I'm going to talk about a couple of emails I got. Freaking crazy people. Buddy's in this, I'm going to have Buddy in the background here. I'm stocking up like a squirrel, collecting nuts for the winter. So I got some hay over here. Been riding around getting hay. If you notice in here, I have some, this is some three-way hay. It's got some oat and rye mix. Up here you get some orchard grass, or some people call it mountain grass. Next to that I got some alfalfa, dry and crusty. Below that I have some rye. Over here I just went and picked up some oat the other day. This is some good oat. And I'm going to go to a different place today where they got some oat hay. Pick that up. Buddy looks like he's pulled a little flake of alfalfa and he's nibbling through it. As you can tell, it's kind of crowded in here. There's a blue tarp there. There's a little bitty door with a turn. Buddy don't have much room to turn around. All this hay in here. Normally he wouldn't come in here, but when it's this crowded, he would just kind of hang at the door and want me to feed him. But the grass is getting a little slimmer out there. It's getting dry, so he obviously felt like he wanted to come in here and get some hay. So anyway, I got these two crazy... Oh, first of all, before I forget, I always forget. All these people telling me, give Buddy a big hug and kiss for me. Come here, Buddy. Hey, stop eating for a minute. You got to get a big hug for all the YouTube people. All right. Buddy got his hug. People sending him all this love. Mean old dad's not giving it to him, ripping him off. So anyway, I got a couple emails that just, first of all, this lady writes me, oh, one of these emails from a guy too, it's a husband. I'll do him first, so I'm always cracking on women. this husband's gonna write me some email and start chewing me out that how mean I am and how dare I talk to his wife that way. And he was just going through her emails, reading some of my emails. First thing I'm thinking, what the hell, you don't go through your wife's email? Is she wants you to read that shit, she'll give it to you. Maybe she gave it to him, I don't know. But he writes me and says, I'm going through my wife's email and I'm reading what you're emailing her, and it's a good thing you're on the internet or I'd punch you in the face and not knock you. So he starts talking all this smack and stuff, and who do you think you are talking to my wife this way, blah, 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 blah. And if I was closer, so I'm just like, really, dude? Look, here's a message to all you husbands out there that don't want me talking to your wife bad. Don't tell her not to contact me, damn it. Ain't that right, buddy? I know. I'm not calling your wife. Your wife's calling me. You know, if when you're going through her emails, you're probably finding she's talking to other guys too, because you ain't stepping up at home or doing whatever. You guys don't want me helping your wife. Don't tell them to call me. You help them. You get involved. If you were more involved and out there helping and learning and getting involved, then they wouldn't have to call me. So if they're calling me, don't be getting pissed off at me, telling me how I should talk to your wife because she contacts me with stupid questions. And you don't want anybody calling your wife stupid because you're too stupid to learn about a horse so you can help her, so she has to go run around the internet and contact anybody. So that's the... I didn't tell him all that. I just responded to him. You know what? You're pretty big behind a computer. Why don't you give me your phone number? I'll give you a call. Where are you located? And of course, I didn't hear from him, but... You know, it's just freaking ridiculous. I get tired of reading these emails from these dumbasses. So anyway, then I get this email from this other girl. And again, this is constant. I delete so many emails, and it's just like, look, I tell you, don't ask questions. It depends. There's too many variables. I cannot help you. Sometimes I can lead you in the right direction. Sometimes I can point you to a video. But if you just search and read, do your research, you can find out yourself. If you're too stupid or lazy to do that, then I'm not going to give you an easy answer. I had some lady write me the other day and said, hey, you know what? I noticed when a couple years ago when I was asking you questions, you never gave me a direct answer. You always kind of gave me hints on where to look or whatever, and I had to go find the answer, and I just realized it made me learn more. Well, perfect. I mean, if you went to school and the stinking teacher gave you all the answers, you wouldn't learn much. You wouldn't learn how to research or how to figure things out. So I'm not here to give easy answers. If you want easy answers, then go buy the special tapes from all these people that have all the answers with their special equipment and special ropes and with their special initials on it, so you can be one of their clones, whatever. So this lady's gonna write me the other day, and like I'm an idiot and give me an email about, you know what, I've got all these horses that I rescued, and my husband was rasping one of the feet, and you know, the back feet was just a little unlevel, so he was going to help the horse and level it out, and with one movement of the rasp, blood started squirting everywhere. Now, normally I delete these questions, but this just irritated me, so I'm like, are you that stupid, or do you think I'm that stupid that I think that one rasp on an overgrown hoof is going to draw blood? You had no business. This is one of those things where, you know, people want to try and help and get involved, and they do damage. So she wants me to give her an answer on how long this will take to heal and how long this is going to hurt the horse. I don't know. It depends on how dumb you were and how deep you went. First of all, if you think that one rasp, if I'm going to believe that an overgrown hoof, that one rasp is going to cause blood, you must think I'm an idiot. And then second of all, whoever freaking rasps that foot doesn't know shit about a hoof, because I mean, I've been doing hoofs for many years and I'm not even a farrier, and I've never made a horse bleed. I can't ever remember making a horse bleed. Because less is more, and I take off little at a time, and I never try to take off a lot. I mean, it's just common sense to me. Do no harm. Your job is to help. As a horseman, your job is to make it better for the horse, not to try things and make it worse for the horse. You try to get involved with the feet and make them level. They obviously weren't that bad. If the hoof is going to bleed from one rasp, which I don't believe for a second, okay, either the dude hit the coronary band, either he went up on a hill and hit one of the bulbs. I mean, he did something, or the hoof was so damn worn down because he's been trying to help so much that he just went down past the sole and started a horse bleeding. I mean, I've never made a horse bleed. So, I mean, to me, it's just freaking stupid. But, you know, so I ride her back and go, you know what the hell, why did you make the horse pay? Why were you getting involved? And of course, she's gonna, you know, then we have to get into this. You're a jerk. You're the biggest asshole on the internet. I hate you. I don't know why. Good. I don't know why you called me either, telling me you hurt a stinking horse. So then I say, well, what do you want? What answer would you like? You write me a question about a hoof, where first of all, you tell me how stupid you are that you're going to make a horse bleed. You tell me you have no knowledge of the hoof, and you want me somehow, never seeing the hoof. I didn't see it before it bled. I didn't see it after you chopped on it. You didn't send me a picture, nothing. And now you want me to give you some magical answer and give you something that'll make you feel good. I said, really? I said, you need to write someone else for that. But I said, just to make you feel better, here's the answer you're looking for. Oh, that's okay. The horse will get better, and don't worry about it. It was an accident, and you were trying to help, so, you know, it's okay. Just don't worry about it. Is that really what you want? Because you're coming to the wrong person to get that. I'm not going to tell you that. I think that's a stupid answer, and I think it's stupid of you to be looking for an answer, and had you done your homework before you made the horse bleed, you wouldn't be looking for an answer. But you wanted to go fast, easy to the heart, and then, of course, you know, she's got to write me back. Well, my husband's been doing feet for 30 years, and he's never done this before, and this is the first time. And look, I don't care. I don't know your husband. Accidents happen. Maybe it was an accident. But regardless, what the hell are you doing writing me wanting a over an email response to something that I have no visual, you know, confirmation? I can't see. I don't know what the horse was being fed. I don't know how long you've had the horse. I don't know what the I don't know anything about this horse, and you want me to give you some magical answer. And that's why I say when people ask questions, you know they don't have a clue, because they're looking for an answer where there is no answer. There's too many. Oh, you changed a little oat there. You got tired of the alfalfa there, buddy? You want to try a little oat? That's why I like feeding horses. You notice Buddy's kind of going to alfalfa. Every once in a while, he'll go to the other side, and he'll grab a little rye, and then he'll come back to this. I don't like feeding just one type of hay. Horses get different minerals and vitamins, just like we have to have variation in our diets. If we ate straight meat and straight protein, it wouldn't be good. If we ate straight carbs, it wouldn't be good. If we ate all sweets, it wouldn't be good. But in variation, we get certain things from certain different foods. Well, horses do the same thing. When you feed your horse straight alfalfa all the time from the same field, from the same buyer, they're going to be lacking certain vitamins and certain minerals that they would get if you varied it.
They don't really like that mountain grass or orchard grass, but sometimes they'll snack through it and pick and just nibble on it. So when I feed, sometimes I'll grab a half a flake of each, or I'll vary it. You know, one day they'll get, you know, a little rye and a little oat. The next day they may get some three-way and some mountain grass, etc. Variation is the key to horses. Nothing in excess. If you give them a little grain, a little bit of a grain is better than trying to feed them a whole bunch and trying to put weight on them. I've talked about this in many videos on how to feed, but just watching Buddy kind of snack around here, eating a little oat, eating a little alfalfa, eating a little rye, he's telling me, listen to your horse, he's telling me that, you know, if I have choice and variation, I'll have a little bit of each. But if you only lock me in a stall and throw me a flake of alfalfa, I have no choice to eat it. So if there's dead birds in it, if there's dead mice in it, if it's moldy, if there's something in it that I shouldn't eat, if it's all I have to eat and I'm locked in a stall and I'm starving in between feedings because I can't nibble on anything, I'm going to eat the bad crap. And then I'm going to be called a stupid horse when I colic, and you're going to have all these vet bills, and you're going to be trying to blame the hay grower or the haymaker or whatever else you want to, or the barn manager. You want to blame somebody else because you lock your horse in a stall and give them bad hay, and then when they have nothing else to eat and they eat it and colic and die, you want to cry and write me about how is it that your horse died and you loved it and it had pink furry booties on and you can't believe it's dead. And then I'm going to be sarcastic, and then you'll be telling me I'm the biggest asshole on the internet, and I'll be blocking you, and the cycle continues. And all right, so anyway, that was my husband and my other stupid thing about the feet. Less is more. If you write me trying to tell me you tried to help a horse and it went bad and the horse got hurt, I'm not a sympathetic guy on that. I speak for the horse. I'm going to get protective of the horse. If you can't understand that, well, then you get what you get. I mean, when you make a comment and I kind of snap on you and you want to write and go, that was mean and there was no sense and they were just... you know what? If you're going to open your mouth and get involved and make a comment that's stupid and I tell you it's stupid, you know, I'm sorry. Somebody posted a picture the other day on Facebook. It's pretty funny. It said, I'm sorry that I hurt your feelings when I called you stupid. I thought you knew. So that's my motto. I thought you knew. Anyway, we'll end that there. Kind of rambling on, covered a couple things. Don't know if you got anything out of it. Hopefully you did. Buddy, you're a good boy. Buddy, look at the camera. Say goodbye. Where'd you go, boy? He's like, dude, I'm eating. All right, we'll end that there.